Hey, it's that time, but I'm in the wrong camera. Why is that? Unusual. Let's try this. Hi, everybody. And I'm not getting my iPhone in there either. What's going on? Jeez, I swear to God. Oh, I know why. How about if I do that? That works. There we go. Hi, everybody. How are you? Happy Thanksgiving. A week early, because I'm not going to perform on Thanksgiving proper, which would be the normal stream night. Unless there's a huge groundswell for me to do something on Thanksgiving, because guess what? I'm going to be right here at home with my loving family. But I think we're going to hang out and do some stuff. Although you never know. I could probably get on for a short amount of time. Hi, John Stapleton. Hey, Ray Gold's on here. My mom is on her. Happy Thanksgiving, Mom. I wish we could be with you. Hello, John Niccolo, Lisa Kemp. The whole gang is here. I'll tell you what. Yeah, we were actually originally going to go down to Florida and spend some time with our family and maybe a week in the sun and all that. But being that the virus is exploding again, we are being responsible no matter how much that sucks, and we're staying home. So I'm glad to be here with you tonight. And I want to let you know that I'm super thankful for all of you people who come on here and week after week join me and make this a pretty enjoyable pandemic as they go, I suppose. I wasn't around for 1918, but couldn't stream back then, right? Hey, Lonnie, how are you? Mike Brennan's on here. Peter Martin's on here. Peter, I thought I just saw you live streaming from a beach somewhere. Where are you? Ah, there you are, from Huatulco. Well, good for you, my man. Good for you. You got the dog down there with you? So I'm just going to play a bunch of stuff. I am super thankful for all of you, as I said, and for having this outlet. And so are many of my previous guests, several of which are going to make an appearance tonight. They're going to come in and do a little something. It'll be short little snippets of people throughout the night, but a lot of people want to say thank you. And I also feel like you may want to see some of them. Now, because it's Thanksgiving and because I'm so very thankful for you all being here, hello, Bobby and Uncle Mike. If you do have a request, put it in the comments, and I'll try to do it because, I mean, it's the least I can do, right? Not the very least, but it's kind of the least. John Stapleton reached out to me earlier today through back channels because he's that kind of guy. He's got that kind of pull. And he asked me to learn this John Hiatt song, which I kind of did. So I'm going to do that one, but I'm not going to start with that since I literally just learned it an hour ago. So I feel like I'm going to let it settle for a minute, and then I will do it. So I'll do something else that has been requested that I have not done before, and hopefully I can remember how to do it. So we'll try this to start. Heading down south to the land of the pines, I'm throwing my way into North Carolina. I'm starting up the road and play to God, I see headlines. I made it down the coast in 17 hours, picking me a bouquet of dogwood flowers. I'm hoping for Raleigh, I can see my baby tonight. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. Running from the cold up in New England, I was born to be a fiddler in an old-time string band. My baby plays the guitar, I pick a banjo now. Oh, North Country winters keep a-getting me down. Lost my money playing poker, so I had to leave town. I ain't turning back to living that old life no more. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, yeah, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, yeah, mama, rock me. walking to the south out of Roanoke. I caught a trucker out of Philly, had a nice long toke. He's a heading west from the Cumberland Gap to Johnson City, Tennessee. I gotta get a move on before the sun. I hear my baby calling my name, and I know that she's the only one. And if I die in Raleigh, at least I will die free. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, yeah, mama, rock me. All right. Christine McCoy. Oh, a modern human song. That was my band in college. And boy, I'll see if I can. That's a big ask. I don't think I remember any of that stuff. Hello, Diane. How are you? I hope Pete's doing well, too. Gladys is on. Cruz Gomez is on. Good to see you, too. But let's not just. You know what? I feel like I have to let John have his moment. No, I'm going to do one more before I do that. There's a young cowboy, he lives on the range. Actually, I don't even know it, do I? He lives on the range. There we go. I'll try it again. Should I try it again? I'm going to try it again. I think I'm thankful that you are so forgiving. There is a young cowboy, he lives on the range. His horse and his cattle are his only companions. He works in the saddle and he sleeps in the canyons, waiting for summer, his pastures to change. And as the moon rises, he sits by his fire, thinking about women and glasses of beer, closing his eyes as the doggies retire. He sings out a song which is soft but it's clear, as if maybe someone could hear. So good night, you moonlight ladies. Rock 'em by, sweet baby James. Creep kings and blues are the colors I choose. Won't you let me go down in my dreams? And rock 'em by, sweet baby James. Now the 1st of December was covered in snow, so was the turnpike from Stockbridge to Boston. The Berkshires seemed dreamlike on account of that frosting. With 10 miles behind me and 10,000 more to go, but there's a song that they sing when they take to the highway, a song that they sing of their home in the sky, song that they sing when they take to the sea. Maybe you can believe it if it helps you to sleep. The singing works just fine for me. So good night, you moonlight ladies. Rock goodbye, sweet baby James. Deep greens and blues are the colors I choose. Won't you let me go down my dreams and rock goodbye, sweet baby James. All right. Hi, Ellen. Tom Kunkel. My gosh, what a night. I am super thankful to have all you folks here. Isn't that nice? Well, I've still got a few things to do before we start bringing on the guests. Oh, and so many guests. All right, I'm going to try this John Hiatt tune. I literally, in my head, can't think of how it goes, but I might have a couple notes here. So we'll see how it goes. Worst comes to worst. Thank you, Dave. That's very nice of you to say. I am going to try it, and if I can't get it, then when one of the guests is doing something, I'm going to give it a quick listen and then do it then. But let's see if I can do it. Pasty! When the road gets dark and you can no longer see, just let my love throw a spark. Have a little faith in me. When you hear the tears you cry, and all you can believe, just give these loving arms a try, baby. Have a little faith in me. Have a little faith. Have a little faith in me. Have a little faith in me. And when your secret heart cannot speak so easily. That's not right. Come here, darling. From a whisper start, to have a little faith in me. And when your back's against the wall, just turn around and you will see. I will catch your fall, baby. Just have a little faith in me. 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 Have a little faith in me.
Oh, nice. I went too quick. Yeah, I'm right.
I've been loving you for such a long time, girl. Expecting nothing in return, just for you to have a little faith in me. Cause in the time, my friend, for us there is no end. All you gotta do is have a little faith in me. I said I will hold you up, I will hold you up. Your love give me strength enough, so have a little faith in me. Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. Woo. Have a little faith in me.
I appreciate that you all have had a little faith in me all this time, and I so much appreciate it. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Rick Diaz, thank you very much.
Well, you know what? I am glad. I'm glad that touched you, Rick, because that's what that's all about, man. By the way, if you are so inclined and you want to throw a tip my way, I will continue to be thankful and grateful. And here's where you can do it. But again, not required. Appreciated, never required. And you know what? It's Thanksgiving, so this is a little gift to you. I will not be upset if you do not send a thing. But if you want to, there it is. And just so you know, next week there will be no show because it's Thanksgiving. But I will be back on December 3rd, and I think next week I'll probably put out something pre-recorded so there's something to watch. And I will also maybe make some announcements about my upcoming guests, because I have several good ones lined up in December. And mark your calendars, folks, for the Christmas Spectacular, which will be the Thursday, a week before Christmas Eve. So I think that's the 17th. I'll have a bunch of info about that. You may remember the fantastic television theme show where I had all those guests send stuff in. Well, I'm going to try and get that to happen again, except with Christmas music. Ah, John Stapleton, you know I can't, I can't deny you. You're too, I don't know. You're too in my head, bro. All right. I still have this new piano sound, which I'm kind of liking. I think I kind of dig it. So I'm going to do another piano-based song. I was testing some last week to see how this thing worked. So we'll do this. We'll do an Elton tune, because that's a good guy to test your piano stuff on. I don't think I did this one last week. If I did, tell me and I'll stop and do something else. If you feel that it's real, I'm on fire, and I'm here in your prison. Like a coin in your mint, I am dented, and I'm spared without treason. Through a glass eye, your throne is the one danger zone. Take me to the pilot of your soul. Take me to the pilot of control. Take me to the pilot, lead me to the chamber. Take me to the pilot, I am not a stranger. Take me to the pilot, lead me to the chamber. Take me to the pilot, I am but a stranger. Na na na, 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 na. Well, I know he's not old, and I'm told he's a virgin. He, maybe she, but what I'm told is never for certain. Through a glass eye, your throne is the one danger zone. Take me to the pilot of control. Take me to the pilot of your soul. Take me to the pilot, lead me to the chamber. Take me to the pilot, I am but a stranger. Take me to the pilot, lead me to the chamber. Take me to the pilot, I am but a stranger. Na na na, 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 na. Is the one danger zone. Take me to the pilot for control. Take me to the pilot of your soul. Woo, take me to the pilot, lead me to the chamber. Take me to the pilot, I am not a stranger. Take me to the pilot, lead me to the chamber. Take me to the pilot, I am but a stranger. Na na na, na na na, na na na, na 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 na, na na na. Na na na, na na na, na 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 na. Oh, take me, take me. Oh, take me, take me, take me. Oh, take me. That thing's got a good sound to it. I do like that piano. I like it a lot. Oh, you know what? Hold on a second. I see. we're starting to get some people showing up in the green room. I like to let them sit in there and, you know, do their blow and whatever else they're doing in there. But I'm sure it's coming. Well, I'm going to do one more, and then it's time to bring out the first guest. And what a guest it is. I got to tell you, it gives me shivers just to know he's here. And mostly because he makes me nervous. I mean, frankly, the guy, he's a big talent, you know. But thankfully, he's a sweetheart of a guy, and he doesn't hold my lack of talent against me, which I really appreciate. All right, so I think I'll do something a little bit more relaxed, right? Well, that makes me think of something else. Makes me think of three. It's a magic number. Yes, it is an imagining number. Faith and hope and charity. Well, whatever. I have that in there, so I should do that tune. I like that. Let me run with you tonight. I'll take you on a midnight ride. Let me in someone I used to see, but she don't give a damn for me. But let me get to the point. Let's roll another joint and turn the radio loud. I'm too alone to be proud. You don't know how it feels. You don't know how it feels to be me. Some grow young, some grow old. I woke up in between a memory and a dream. So let's get to the point and let's roll another joint and let's head on down the road. Somewhere I gotta go, and you don't know how it feels. You don't know how it feels to be me. Still trying to beat the clock. Think of me what you will, I got a little space to fill. So let's get to the point, let's roll another joint, and let's head on down the road. There's somewhere I gotta go, and you don't know how it feels. No, you don't know how it feels. No, you don't know how it feels to be me. And you don't know how it feels. No, you don't know how it feels. No, you don't know how it feels to be me. Tom Petty to get you going. All right. Oh, we've got all the stars are showing up in the green room. Again, they're just in there enjoying the nose candy and, you know, having a little Thanksgiving cheer. But I think it's time. Hi, Jeff and Susie. How are you? How about that? I know what you mean, Christine. Me too. So, we have a new technology available to us here at C-Nev's Place here for interviewing. So, we're going to try something new. So, let's see what we can do. I was actually channeling Tom Petty. But I understand the thought. All right, so let me go over here to my new interview station. And let's get that rolling. Come on now. Where is it? Interview. There it is. And I just need to go to my other camera, which is right here. Well, except that's in the way now. There, that's where I'm supposed to be. Hi, everybody. So we are now in the interview space. And I believe the great Pat Brennan is standing by. And I think I'm going to assign him. I think I'm going to bring him in. I'm going to add him to my left. Pat? Pat, are you listening? Pat? Pat. There he is. You see. And you're on.
Oh.
I like that you dressed for it.
Huh?
I said, I like that you dressed for it. You're looking sharp in there.
Oh, thanks.
I like it.
Oh, I got the echo on.
Uh-oh. I'm not hearing it.
I am. Oh.
Well, this will be exciting. We had all kinds of interesting experiments this afternoon.
I was doing blow in the green room.
Well, you know, it takes your eye off the ball, my friend. Not the eight ball, but the other ball.
Okay, I'm trying to hear this. But I don't know if it's going to work.
Nothing is more entertaining than watching people solve tech problems on the live stream.
This is driving me crazy. I'm hearing my voice coming at me.
Oh, that's weird, because I'm not hearing it at all. It's perfect on this end.
Okay. Let's see if I can show the kind of mental acuity I don't have in me.
Do you want me to send you back to the green room? You can work on that, and I'll bring out Chris Siebold instead.
Yeah. Bring out Chris. Let's take a look and see what Chris is doing.
Oh, there he is. All right, I'm going to let you go back, Pat. I'm bringing you back into the green room. Guess what, Chris Siebold? You're on camera.
Oh, my goodness, it's me.
How are you, Chris?
I'm pretty good, man.
I'm good. Happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah, Merry Christmas. Happy Thanksgiving.
So what have you been doing with yourself during these terrible times?
Well, I've been doing some... What have I been doing? Teaching.
Wait a minute. There is a...
Still trying to get home costume material together. I'll try all sorts of things at the moment.
Okay. I think I fixed the echo. Ellen, let me know if I did. I think I just fixed the echo. I'll have to text Pat and tell him he can come back. So, have you got any gigs coming up anywhere, or is the winter shutting you down as it is so much?
Well, the winter's shutting me. Remarkably, I still have my gig at a place called Pinstripes in Oak Brook. They haven't contacted me to tell me I'm fired yet, so I'm going to be there tomorrow and Saturday.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
And it's a cool situation. It's all socially distanced and everything, and I'm basically 30 yards away from anybody else. Nobody really comes and bugs me, but I am singing and playing, and that's been a blessing. I mean, I've been doing that since the end of July, so I've been one of the lucky ones. And still teaching at Elmhurst for a little bit. I got some students besides that I'm working with over Zoom, and I'm trying to write a record right now. I'm trying to my goal for the winter months is to write a bunch of material and release it on SoundCloud, just voice and guitar, and then to later develop that material into new cycles arrangements. So
nice. For those of you who are not familiar with cycles, PSYCHLES.
That's right. It's so hippie, dude. So
yeah,
hippie.
It really is. I mean, dude, you blew my mind just with the name. But it's a great band that is is embodied by Chris Siebold, and I really liked the last record, so I'm hoping the next one is even half as good would be great.
Well, yeah, I mean, the next one will be a studio record, so it'll be, you know, the first one was a live one, which we did at Martyrs, and I should mention, I'm doing a little streaming show at the venue in Aurora on Sunday, in Scott Tipping's series, The Venues at the Venue. Will be interviewing Ray Quinn of Martyrs, and I'll be playing a couple of songs before and after and doing a little bit of question and answer just to hear Ray's story, and because he's got lots of them, but also to highlight the importance of venues like Martyrs surviving, coming out the other end of this thing, because lots of venues are struggling, as you know.
Speaking as a venue owner, I appreciate it, because it is not a good scene for us at all. There is just not.
No, it's just nothing really good about it, actually.
No, no. And I mean, granted, we do have some good news theoretically on the front with the vaccine coming, but it's going to be a while before live music is back. So, so all you people out there, thank you for being a part of this and for
Thank you for, you know, patronizing the home concert series. I mean,
that's exactly right.
I know you've had a lot of success with C-Nev's Place.
C-Nev's been okay. I got a logo and everything.
Yeah, and I took a break from my concerts, but during the lockdown, my concerts were pretty successful. I'm kind of fighting the where have you been and we lost you, and of course the algorithms are working against me now. But I hope to get it back by the time that everything does shut down, because you know, it's going to be my only real outlet to perform for people, you know.
Well, we'll have to get you back in for a show here, I think, probably.
Yeah, it'd be a lot of fun. Well, we had a blast the first time.
Yeah, we should do that again. So I'm going to put you on the calendar.
All right. Well, you know, we can, your people call my people, you know, my agent's really busy talking to other agents.
Good for you.
That don't have any work. And so they're just basically commiserating. They're not really talking about
I just
about
cut you out. I didn't mean to do that.
Oh, it's okay. I wasn't really saying anything of real consequence.
Well, I know that, but even still. So would you like to do a song for us, Chris?
Yeah, I have to ask a question first. But this is a Thanksgiving show, and I know that you have a lot of musical luminaries coming on here, and you may have even done this tune, so I just want to make sure nobody's done it.
What?
Harvest Moon.
It's all you, baby.
All right.
Here, hold on. I'm gonna flip us around so that you're... Wait a minute. I want to switch that. There we go. That's what I want.
Oh,
all right.
Look at that. Well, you're flipping all around the place there.
You know, that's just the way I work.
So this tune, I love it, and I have my own little version of it, but I do cut the time in between the verses. So I'm just going to do this for you real quick, and much love to you, Chris, and thanks for having me, and thanks you for everything that you do. Come a little closer, hear what I have to say. Just like children sleeping, we could dream this night away. There's a full moon rising, let's go dancing in the night. Music's playing, let's go out and feel the night. Cause I'm still in love with you, I won't see you dance again. Cause I'm still in love with you. Love is harvest moon. Thank you.
it's getting late, and the moon is climbing high. I want to celebrate, see it shining in your eyes. Cause I'm still in love with you, I won't see you smile again. Cause I'm still in love with you on this harvest moon. Cause I'm still in love with you, I won't see you dance again. I'm still in love with you. Oh, this harvest moon.
That was very, very pretty, Chris.
Well, you know, you can't go wrong with Neil Young, I always say.
I agree with you. I agree with you.
You notice that I cut some of the interludes in the verses, so it kind of moved along a little quicker, you know.
You know, and that's
why. I feel like there's plenty of space in that tune for.
But that's why you're a pro. That's why you're a show business. We all know that about you.
Well, you know, it's like, you got 2 minutes, baby, so make some edits.
All right. Love you, pal. And we'll get together soon, I hope. Yeah.
Yeah. Let's text or whatever. Give me a call. We'll figure out a day and we'll do it.
That sounds good. All right, buddy. Chris Siebold, everybody.
Yay. Thank you.
Catch your stream. When's your stream again? This weekend?
My stream is going to be Wednesday at 10 o'clock, Wednesday of next week. So Black Wednesday, it'll be spent here.
Excellent.
And it's going to be great.
So once you're done pushing someone over to get a TV.
Once I've actually killed somebody, just by stamping them to death,
yes.
I will.
Yes.
I'll come home and do a nice little virtual concert for you.
Sounds beautiful. All right, pal.
All right, man.
See you soon.
Bye-bye.
How about that? Chris Siebold. But, you know, we have other people waiting in the green room. I'm going to bring out Pat Brennan again, just to see if it works. I see you in there, Kevin. Don't worry. You're coming. I promise. There he is. Oh, you know what? That doesn't have to be there anymore. We can get rid of that. But you can be there. Is this better? Have we lost the echo?
Hello. We lost it.
That's fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, my partner in crime, Mr. Patrick Brennan.
I was so worried.
You may not know this, but you do if you've been watching the stream, but Pat and I have a newish podcast. We are 3 episodes in now. New episodes drop on Wednesday. The new one just dropped yesterday. We're only speaking verbally. You can find it wherever you find your podcast, and it's pretty good, if I do say so myself. John Rice himself.
Oh, look at that.
John Rice himself gave it a gave it a plus, and that means something. Because John doesn't hand out those kind of compliments for nothing.
No, we got two hot compliments right in a row.
Two heavyweights. I love it.
And then there's the Russian contingent.
Yeah. So our first episode was about musical conspiracy theories. It was called Stevie Wonder Can See. And then the last two episodes, 2 and 3, were a two-parter about Prague. And it's called What's a Four-Letter Word That Women Don't Like? And it's all about Prague rock. And it's pretty good. I think you would all benefit from seeing it. And listening to it.
I got an email from a Canadian woman that I know who was upset that we only referenced French-Canadian women liking Genesis. And she said, I'm an English-Canadian woman who lives in Toronto, and I love Peter Gabriel.
Well, she's an outlier.
Yeah. Chris Siebold, starting slow and going downhill, to quote Neil Young.
That's right. Kind of starts out slow and then fizzles out altogether.
Yeah.
But, you know, how do you get to the podcast? If you, Jeff Thrall is asking, well, if you want to find the podcast, I don't know where you listen to your podcasts, but if you do on Spotify or on Apple Music or something like that, if you search for We're Only Speaking Verbally, it will come up. You can also search for it on Stitcher. I don't know if we're in the Pandora library yet. We're certainly heading there. Google Play Store, all that stuff. So essentially, wherever you get podcasts, you probably can find us. So it's called We're Only Speaking Verbally.
You could actually, if you just Google We're Only Speaking Verbally, it'll take you right there.
There you go. There you go. And we will be releasing on Wednesday, right before Thanksgiving, our special politics, music in politics episode, which we just did, and it's really good. It's very
entertaining. It actually is good. It is good. I listened to a little bit of it today, and it's we're very perceptive for people that generally aren't perceptive. I think we're very perceptive.
If we do say so ourselves, and we do. So there now you go.
Let's talk about Kevin Trim.
Kevin Trim. Yeah, you know, so we have in the guest room right now, the great Kevin Trim is sitting there, standing there, I guess. And he didn't know he was going to come on, but I called him because I said, "You are the most thankful man I know. You come and support live music everywhere you can go. You are absolutely one of the best live music fans I know and one of my best friends, period. And so why would I not want him on the podcast?" And I thought he was just going to come on and take accolades and, you know, be happy. But no, he wants to do a song. So he's going to do a song. Matter of fact, Kevin, I'm going to bring you out here with Pat and I. There you are. Look at that. Kevin Trim.
Hey. How are you?
I'm doing
Pat
good.
Pat Brennan, you're looking sharp.
I wore a tie because an ex-FBI friend of mine named Bud Hall was making fun of me for wearing a t-shirt on an internet show.
And if Bud Hall jumped off a bridge, would you jump off a bridge, Pat?
If he asked me to, I would, yes.
How high, sir?
Yes.
So, Kevin. How are you, my friend?
Doing great, and in honor of you, I also have my Steinmart shirt on.
There you go.
And Vans on my feet.
Oh, I can't see your feet, but I trust you.
I'm all C-Nev today.
I love it. That's fantastic. I appreciate it.
I've actually prepared a song for Kevin.
You have?
Yes, I have a song.
Well, then,
and the name of the song is Kevin Trim.
Do you need full screen for this? Or you want to do it while we're both up here?
No, I think we should. I should do it when you're both up there, so we can watch Kevin's reaction.
By all means, Pat.
Okay. Uh oh.
Won't talk about my friend. His name's Kevin Trim. About 5'4".
Oh.
From the hood to him. Comes round here just about midnight. He makes Cindy feel so good. Makes Cindy feel all right. Name is K.
K.
E.
E.
V.
V.
I.
I.
N. 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 K. E. V. I. N. Trim.
K. E. V. I. N. Trim.
K. E. V. I. N. Trim. I'm gonna shout all night. Sing this song on whim. Here we go.
Oh, Pat. Ladies and gentlemen, the great Pat Brennan bringing it for Kevin Trim, as we all should.
Wow, man. Thank you, Pat.
You're welcome, Kevin. Anytime. That's, of course, a reprise from something we did at your birthday show.
Yep.
Your surprise birthday show at Wire, and it was fantastic. And was I just replicated it, finally.
And I was very honored that you were there.
Yes.
Well
yes,
done.
And I told the story about how we first met.
You don't have to. My girls are on.
Your girls are on?
Yeah.
Well, they should know this about you.
No.
I mean, you know, it's 2020. We could say things about ourselves that you've hidden for a long time. Okay, I won't tell it. You can relax.
It seems dangerous, Pat.
It is. It Funny. Ruins everything.
Oh my God. All right. Well, that was lovely. That was absolutely fantastic, Pat. Thank Kevin, you. Are you going to do a song for us?
Oh, you want me to do a song?
I would love you to do a song. I mean, just so you all know, so because there will be probably as many as 2 to 5 people who don't know who you are on the stream, assuming there's less than 1,000 on the stream. Kevin is a longtime music fan, but he has taken up the instruments and learned to play them his own damn self. I assume because we're not playing enough for his liking, and he wants to have live music more often. but you know what? It's wonderful to have someone who loves music as much as you do to be able to pick it up and inject yourself into it because you get it. And that's a beautiful thing.
Well, I'll tell you, just this corridor that we live in, there are so many great musicians, and I'm just honored to right, like right now, being with the two of you. And I know Chris Siebold earlier, everybody. I mean, I'm thankful for you as much as anything. So thank you.
We can't blame you for that.
I know.
You're damn right. Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. Let me see if I can make this happen. I think if I do this, yeah. See?
Oh, yeah.
Me and Pat can judge you from on high.
All right. Hey, can I show you one thing before I start real quick?
Yes, absolutely.
Can you see the Marshall amp in the corner?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, no.
Are you going to do
just eruption? Got this. It's really powerful.
Yes.
And it also holds a great Stella.
That's fantastic. The Marshall fridge.
Which I will have after this.
That's so good. All right.
So I thought I was going to do something a little uplifting because it's just such a negative time. So I'm going to do Janis Ian's at 17, if that's okay.
Right. Excellent idea.
No, I think this song is pretty fitting for what we're going through and what we've gone through. So as I walk wicked world, searching for light in the darkness of, I ask myself, is all hope lost? Is it just pain and hatred and misery? And each time I feel like this inside, there's one thing I want to know. Oh, why did I screw that up? And each time I feel like this, each time I feel, ooh, here we go. Ready?
Ready.
I'm in the green room. Let me out now. As I walk through this wicked world, searching for light in the darkness of misery, I ask myself, is all hope lost? Is it just pain and hatred and misery? And each time I feel like this inside, there's one thing I wanna know. What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Oh, what's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? As I walked these troubled times, to where I was strong, who I trusted, to where I was strong, who I trusted, where is a harmony, sweet harmony? And each time I feel like this inside, there's one thing I wanna know. What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Oh, what's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Oh. And each time I feel like this inside, there's one thing I wanna know. What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Oh, what's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Oh, what's so funny about peace, love, and understanding?
And Trim.
Woo! Something's wrong with my guitar. It hit some bad notes.
That was fantastic. That was tremendous.
Thank you very much, man, for having me on. And I really am grateful for you both and for everybody.
Well, we are very grateful for you, and I wanted to make sure we got you on here for that. Jenny Vieneman's going to be on here in a minute. I know she feels the same way because she's been saying
nice. Another incredible talent and sweet, sweet person.
Andon is giving you compliments in the comments. So
I love Andon too.
You know what?
I love them all. Keep them coming.
Oh, John Stapleton has the best quote of all, though. He says, "Of all the songs I've heard on this show, that was the most recent."
All right, John.
All right, my friend. Well, you are the best, man. We will... I'm sure we'll get together and have a beer outside before it gets to be too cold to have a beverage that's not frozen.
That sounds great. I think I'm going to have one right now.
Oh, it must be a Stella. It's Kevin. It must be Stella time. All right. Well, I will see you later, my friend. I'm going to send you back to the green room. You can stay on there for as long as you like, or you can...
So long, Kevin.
Or you can...
Thank you, Pat. I love your Facebook posts.
Which one?
All of them.
Oh, okay.
That's a lot. That's Tolstoy level reading. All right, Kevin Trim is back in the green room. Pat, I'm going to throw you back in the green room in a minute too, but let me just do that for a second. Don't go anywhere. I'm going to bring it back. But I have to, real quick, my two children here, come step forward a little bit. They came up to say, what?
Happy Thanksgiving.
There we go.
24 minutes ago.
There you go. There you go.
We said to come down at 8, so we were down here, and then we were just sitting there.
You know.
Said, there's two people in the waiting room. And we were
This is important that you learn.
Like,
this is how showbiz works. You don't know, you know, you gotta roll with it sometimes.
I know.
Yeah. We did.
So they were going to perform tonight, but they've decided to hold off for the Christmas spectacular.
Yes.
Which will be happening in a few weeks, December 17th, I think is the date. I want Pat Brennan, I know you're still listening. I want you to do a song for that. Kevin Trim, if you want to do a video and a song for the Christmas show, you can now because you've been a guest on the show. All right. So happy Thanksgiving from
us.
From Rowan and from Guinevere.
Yeah.
Hi.
And we'll let them go back upstairs and get on their iPads, whatever they're doing.
Cool.
Okay, kiddo. I'll see you. Bye.
Bye.
All right. All right. I'm going to bring Pat back out for just a minute. Where are you? I'm going to go. I'm going to send you left, I think. And there you are.
I loved that they came in and totally gave you grief. Yes,
that is.
We were supposed to be on at 8, Dad.
Well, that's kind of, that's the way it is. Matt Spiegel's on here. Hello, Maddie. How are you, pal? Good to see you. I am very thankful for you and for all of the Tributosaurus brethren as well. But I think I'm going to do another song or two and wait for Miss Bieniemann to show up because I know she's coming. And
she's holding you up?
She's not holding me up. It's casual. Yes, they are, Lisa. They are getting incredibly large. But that is that's what they do, as I understand it. So I guess I'm glad they're doing it because otherwise we'd be doing it wrong. You know, we got all kinds of good comments going. This is a nice thing. I'm glad I'm doing this, and I will go a little long with the music because we're doing a lot of talking. But talking is fun too.
Sure, we're trying to make a career out of talking.
That is true. Hey, and as long as we're talking about talking, I should bring up we're only speaking verbally. So one more, okay, Jenny, but you got to come into the green room. There she is. Hold on. Don't go anywhere, Pat. We'll bring Jen on. Where is she?
Speaks. Much thankfulness to you two and the boys.
Hi, Jenny. Oh,
there she is.
How are you? You know what? I'm going to make it look like, I'm going to say it's Fitzgerald's at 1:30. Let me just add him in too. And then, see, now it looks like Fitzgerald's at 1:30.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. But now I did something wrong. All right, I'm gonna look at this. More guests are joining. My gosh. I almost forgot that David was coming. Well, anyway, Pat, that's Jenny. Where's Pat?
Here
Pat, you're there. Pat, I think I'm gonna let you go. So I'm going to put you back in the green room so that I can talk to Jenny for a little bit, and then David Blamires is sitting in there too.
Excellent. So I'm leaving. Right?
Okay.
I'm leaving.
And we should we'll talk tomorrow about editing.
Everything. We'll talk about everything. Hi, Jenny. By the way, can I say one thing about Jenny Bieniemann?
Please do.
She puts on this act that she's, you know, Earth Mother loving. She's deep and she's dark. Ladies and gentlemen, just don't believe 90% of what she says because there's a whole other thing going on.
Don't believe that.
That's all I want to say.
Tell people.
No, I got that. Nobody believes me. I keep saying it and nobody believes me. But I will keep saying it.
All right, there we go.
Okay, Chris, Jenny, goodbye.
I'll see you later. All right, Jenny, it's you and me now. How are you?
Chris, I'm fantastic. Can you hear me okay?
You sound a little muffled.
Let's see what we can do about that.
You sound like maybe your phone.
Now.
That's way better.
Okay. All right. Well, I'm looking at you on my computer, and I'm looking at you on my phone, and I'll tell you what. You can't have too much Chris Neville in your life.
I think there are many who would disagree, but I'm glad that you don't think that.
I, too, am vibing on your daughters and their good night to you. That was fantastic.
Well, they are the best. I'm very pleased. And I believe Rhonda is also going to be on the Christmas show.
Oh, my dad. So Rhonda is the best.
It's going to be quite the spectacular. And I hope that you will join us on the Christmas show. So I'm giving you 3 weeks notice. Start getting a song together, a Christmas song video.
Twist my arm. I'll be there.
All right. That's all I'm asking. So you're on. We have actually a purpose having you on here, aside from just being thankful to be friends. We have a thing this weekend that everybody can attend, don't we?
We sure do, Chris. But first of all, I do want to say I am so thankful for you being hilarious and awesome and bringing us all together like that. And if I may say, that cover of the Tom Petty song, that was awesome. That was really, really great.
Thank you.
Chris Siebold, bringing the holidays, right?
Yes.
And then Mr. Trim himself showing us how it's done. Well, I have my own contribution for the holidays, Chris.
All right.
I don't want to be left out. I made up a book.
Wait a minute. A book?
There it is.
Volume 2.
I made up a book. Haiku Milieu Volume 2. It's full of pictures and haiku and deep thoughts about life. You want to hear one?
Yes.
Okay. Deep thought number one. I unplugged the clock, since now is the only time it will ever be.
Okay, I got it. I mean, whoa.
Okay, here's another one. This one is based on a painting my husband made. Okay, can you see it?
A little bit.
You might not be able to see it. All right, but here, are you ready for this deep thought?
I'm ready.
Artists lose themselves in everything they create, hoping we will too.
Come on. You know.
It's like I didn't even write these. I can't even believe it. And well, then I also made a tiny book. This book
that is,
three and a half by 4 inches. And it contains the haiku that you and Dog wrote a song to.
Yes.
Do you remember how that haiku goes?
Do I remember? Off the top of my head, I remember it was fairly dark.
It goes, speaking of bull.
You can swear, it's okay.
I have had enough of yours. You can F right off.
That is the haiku that we chose.
So that's what I have for you tonight.
So
you're in my little room, as you can see.
I can. I want to get that on there.
Yeah.
So the 20th, this Saturday. No, this
Friday.
Tomorrow, sorry. Mm-hmm. Tomorrow is the big Haiku Milieu 2. I don't know how to describe the event. It is a cavalcade of stars and talent and fun. It's really a good time.
Thank you for introducing the word cavalcade into this event tonight.
Well, if the word fits.
Moniker?
Yeah, if the moniker fits. Thank you. See, it's all about trading. But so you had a bunch of different folks, some of whom I know in a lot this time that are new to me anyway. And everybody chooses a haiku from your plethora of excellent poetry. And they write a song based on it. And this one's collaborative efforts, right? So it's like Doug Julian and I did one. You did one with Ron Lazzaretti. Is that correct?
Steve Dawson,
Brian
Dawson. Anderson. Yeah. A couple guys from out of town.
Yep. And I know John Langford's going to be there.
He wrote a great, great song.
And
everybody wrote great songs.
The Yellowhammers is so good. But I will say, this is a really, really fun event. It's being done streaming from Fitzgerald's, even though it won't be attended by anybody. It still gives you the vibe, right?
And yeah, nobody will be at Fitzgerald's, but hopefully we can all be at home. And everybody's written these songs, and they've made videos. And if you've ever been around people who are at the early part of learning how to do something, you know how alive it is. It's like, maybe not perfect, but it's so alive. And this show is exactly like that. It's just amazing. It's going to be as close to being live and in person as we could possibly be.
That is the nicest way of saying they're not very professional that I've ever heard.
Well, I have 2 videos in it myself. So maybe I'm just trying to make myself feel better.
So what are the details of this? How can people see it?
Okay. So We're actually doing a little private pre-party toast, and this is happening on Zoom. If you go to the event page on Facebook, you'll see where you click the link to register for the Zoom party. And John Langford, Robin and I, Ron Lazzaretti, we're going to play a song for you. So that is going to be live. And Will hopefully is going to say a few words if he doesn't get caught up elsewhere. And then at 7:30 on the nose, streaming from the Fitzgerald's page, is the book release concert. And we have 16 artists. Many, like you've said, Chris, have been on this show or are from the neighborhood. And then for this one, just because 2020, where we've all been in lockdown, it really has been the year of collaboration, I seeded the group with some ringers from outside the community. So we've got Ingrid Groudens, who used to live here but now lives in Nashville. We've got Rod Picott, who's played at Fitzgerald's a few times, is a big Nashville writer. We have Sam Fraser from North Carolina. We have Claudia and Bruce Russell from California. So we're just kind of making a melting pot of musical styles and influences. And I will tell you, the show is just... it's going to make you feel good. Don't watch the show unless you want to feel better, I guess is what I would say. You know,
well, and
if
I gotta
you
say,
want to feel bad, don't watch the show.
And I got to say, it's such a great concept. And I've done two of them now, and I love both of the songs that came out of them. And I think
I love
that,
them too.
And I think it's a really great creative exercise. And it's cool to see all these writers come in and put stuff together based on the haikus. It's really interesting.
It's fascinating for me too. And I just have to shout out to you, Chris, because you like, I don't know, you the well you draw up your musical water from is deep. And your video with Dog is awesome. But also the last song you wrote, which I remember you playing at Friendly Tap, right?
Yeah.
November last year.
Yeah.
Such a great song. I don't know if that's on the list for tonight, but I would put that in the requests.
Oh, I can do that song. I
would love to hear that.
So everybody should go Haiku Malu 2 this Saturday. See, I typed that while you were telling me.
Great. Any multitasks, America?
So make sure that you tune in. It really is a great event. It's going to be a lot of fun. So, wait, I was wrong, though. Did I say Saturday? It's not Saturday. It's Friday.
No, you said it. You said it, but it is definitely tomorrow.
I typed in Saturday. So let me save that, and I'm going to show it again. Hey, everybody, it's Friday from Fitzgerald's Facebook page.
I suggest you watch Haiku Milieu and then you watch Netflix or Amazon Prime or Disney Plus or whatever your streaming thing is.
There
but,
you
like, are. Hang out with your friends. And the TV will mean so much more after we've all hung out together.
It is the truth. It is the truth. Are you going to do a song for us or are you just here to plug and go?
No.
Either way is fine.
Nah.
You're not going to do
so. I regaled you with my verbose haikus.
Yes, you did. And they were tremendous. I appreciate it. Well, I'm really
Thanks
looking forward
for
to it.
Me.
It's going to be a blast. And I'll see you tomorrow.
Sounds good.
All right.
All right. Talk to you soon.
Put you back in the green room. And I'm going to bring out David Blamires. Here he comes. Here he comes.
Oh.
Dave, how are you?
You made this this afternoon?
Yeah. I fixed the left right thing. I figured out what it was.
Oh, good. Oh, you
it,
did. So, okay. Yeah. I fixed my thing too. I'm not getting any feedback anymore. So
that's fantastic. How are you?
I'm doing good, bud. How you doing?
I'm doing all right.
Did we have a couple of great gigs over the last like 6 weeks?
So good.
They were so much fun.
Yeah. They were really good.
The golf course in Geneva. Thank you, Julie.
Yep.
That was like so great. It was so much fun.
And then the patio
then
at Fitzgerald's which
last
was
week. Yeah,
awesome.
We really had a ball. So,
Greg Neese, look at you. You're over here saying
there
hi,
he
David.
Hi, Greg. Yeah, Greg, I think you, like Pat Brennan, you got to be a little more political, okay?
That's the problem.
Yeah.
He needs to write a little bit more about birds.
A little bit. Tell us how you really feel.
You need to write a little bit more about birds and bird photography. So how are things treating you?
I mean, people are constantly asking me, how are you holding up? What you doing? But I've been working at home for 14 years. So, you know, it's really not a big transition. I write music all day long, and I have been doing that in Chicago for 23 years now. So, and I used to go to a recording studio, music production facility every day and write there, but I've been writing from home for the last 14 years. So it's what I do, you know, and so my life hasn't changed that much. I've got four pets, and I like to cook, and I play music, and I write music. So life is actually really good, and I'm being very safe.
You are living the you're kind of living the suburban dream.
Yeah. But listen, plug time. I have released three singles this year.
Yes,
three.
You have.
And they're all on Spotify, Apple, YouTube, Amazon, blah, 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 under my name. And I've been collaborating with these two really great longtime friends from Toronto who live in Mexico. And they haven't been out of Mexico, you know, since whatever. But there are worse places to hang out for 8 or 9 months. Yeah. It's actually on the Pacific coast. It's beautiful. Huatulco. He plays bass and mixes. And Emily sings. Emily Claire Barlow is her name. She's a very well-known, internationally known jazz singer. And I sing and play. And we do all this music together. And I've really had a ball. We got something new coming out in another month and a half. Emily and I are doing a duet. And we're just going to keep going. You know, having fun, and these songs of mine have been kicking around in the vault for like 10 years, so it's kind of nice to have them brought to life and have them out there. So
you're getting a lot of nice comments right now about how great they are. Yes, and you know what, I've listened to them, they really are good, Dave.
Oh, I mean, that's fantastic, thank you so much.
Yeah, you don't get to see Nev's place without having some talent, my friend.
You know where I did all my vocals?
Right there.
Right here. I did. Well, I did them all right here into this mic, which is Earhole Studios mic. Thank you, Adam, for this. Let me borrow this mic.
You shouldn't have said that. Now it's out there. Now it's on the internet. Yeah. John Paul saying hello, the third X's member, and Andon's on here too. Oh, we have all of the X's people here, and we can't play together. But maybe we'll figure something out at some point. So, David,
can I play something?
I would love for you to play something. Do you have something in mind, or are you taking requests?
No. I'm going to play something, and I've actually done this a couple of times. It's in my life, but I haven't done it in a long time. I haven't really even rehearsed it, so it's going to be loose. But here's the thing, it can't be any looser than the recording.
So which Neil Young tune is this?
How's the level? Because I changed my thing. Can you hear this okay? Okay, good.
Yeah, that's great.
I'm gonna turn my reverb on. It's a Bob Marley tune. I'm going to do some reverb here. And, how's that? Can you hear my reverb?
I'm not getting the reverb.
Oh, well.
I always feel like reverb is wasted on a voice like yours.
Let's troubleshoot that for half an hour, Chris. What do you think?
That's what the people come for.
Okay, ready?
March on ship. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit, but my aim was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We fought in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever had, redemption song, redemption song. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. have no fear for atomic energy, cause none of them gonna stop at this time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Ooh, some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the boom. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? It's all I ever had. Redemption song. Redemption song. Redemption song. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our mind. Have no fear for atomic energy, cause none of them are gonna stop at the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the boo. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? Is all I ever had. Redemption song. These songs of freedom. Is all I ever had. Redemption song. Redemption song. Redemption song.
Irie Mon.
You know, that's hilarious because I was going to do that song next. No joke. No joke. I had that up.
No way. I started we'll do it. No shit. No kidding. Wow.
Yeah, come on now. Family show. Not really, but
isn't that a great song?
It's so good. It's so good. Beautiful. I actually sang it, it really resonates with me. Yeah, see?
I have no idea what he's talking about, but it
I had it ready to go right there.
No. That's hilarious.
But you know what? I quite liked your version. So I will save that one. I'll do it next time. No big deal.
Right. Well, thanks for having me on, Chris.
Dave, and, I am thankful to have you in my life. You're a good man.
Yeah. And I'm thankful for you, too. We have a lot of fun together. We play music. We hang out.
Yeah.
We do a lot of laughing. I wish you had more of a sense of humor, but, you know, I'll deal.
I'm hoping I get a book or something for Christmas about it. Maybe if I read about it, I'll be funnier. We'll see.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, the great David Blaine Myers. Give it up.
Thanks, everybody.
All right, Pally. See you later.
Yep.
Wow. Well, that was fun. That was a cavalcade of guests. How about that? That was really nice. Well, I'm going to do a couple of songs, too, because I can. I mean, it's my show, right? What are they going to do? Say no? Dave, rather. I thought that was Melanie Skidmore. Dave Skidmore. I also am very thankful for Dave. He's a great guy. He's a great musician. And it's really wonderful to have a guy like that in our circle because he has done some great things and continues to. So. Anyway, so again, I am thankful for all of you. Wait, I got to get back over here, I think. I think that should work. Doesn't want to work. It's okay. I'll do it manually. I'm in the process of kind of restructuring down here, so it means not everything works all the time. But there we go. All right, so I am so grateful to all of you for supporting this effort of doing some music in a time when we can't. And now we are heading into, by all accounts, not such a great winter. It's going to be a little tough. Oh, let me see if I can get that centered a little better. Nope, not that way. That there we go. That's better. So we're gonna have a little bit of a tough time. But I'm going to be doing this. I will be doing this all the way through the winter months and probably beyond. I really enjoy doing it. So I hope you will continue to come. I hope you will like and subscribe on the YouTube channel if you have not. It means a lot. if you are so inclined, you can send a tip to me at those places, and I will gleefully accept it and gratefully accept it. Really, I mean, you guys are the best, and it means a lot to have an outlet for all of this, you know? I think it's pretty important. So anyway, let me get rid of that. Let me get rid of those. No more begging. That's it. So I'm going to do a couple of songs. If anybody has any ideas of what they want to hear, feel free to put it up there, and I'll see what I can do. But in the meantime, I'll just do some stuff that I want to do, because why not, right? How about... what have I not done lately? Oh, that's right. I was going to do this last week, and I did not. I talked last week about a Phil Collins tune I wanted to do, so I'm going to do it. Melanie, Steely Dan. I will do a Steely Dan song also, but I'll do this first because I really want to. Oh, and Kevin Trim's still out there. I know which tune he wants to hear, and I will do that song. I haven't done it in a while. Roof is leaking and the wind is howling. The kids are crying 'cause the sheets are so cold. I woke this morning, found my hands were frozen. I tried to fix the fire, but you know the damn thing's too old. It's been months now since I heard from Mary. I wonder if she ever made the coast. Well, she and a young man, they both moved out there. I sure hope they ride just to let us know. Oh, no keyboards? Is that true? Damn it. You know what? I'm going to do it all over again. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm glad you enjoyed the a cappella version. But I'm going to get it back to here. Now there's a keyboard, isn't there? Ha ha! Do you mind if I start over? We're in bonus time right now, so I'm going to start over. She and a young man, they both moved out there. I sure hope they're right, just to let us know. And me, I'm getting stronger by the minute. My wife's expecting, but I hope she can wait. 'Cause this winter looks like it's gonna be another bad one. But spring will soon be here. Whoa. Gotta hope it's not late. Ma and Pa live there, there's before them. They tried hardest to make it a home. It seems so long now since they passed over. I hope my children try to make it their own. The roof is leaking and the wind is howling. The kids are crying 'cause the sheets are so cold. Woke this morning, found my hands were frozen. Oh, I tried to fix the fire, but you know the damn thing's too old. And me, I'm getting stronger by the minute. My wife's expecting, but I hope she can wait. 'Cause this winter looks like it's gonna be another bad one. But spring will soon be here. Whoa. Gotta hope it's not late. Little Phil Collins. That's a nice tune. I like that song. A lot of people don't think of Phil Collins when they think of that tune, but that's who did it. A little different, huh? All right, so what did I say I was going to do? Oh, that's right. Okay, so let me just pull it up. Although, do I really need lyrics for this song? I have done this song hundreds of times, literally hundreds of times, and yet I still lean on the crutch. This is the beauty and the horror of having an iPad. It makes you feel like you need it, even when you don't. Thank you, Alicia. Thank you, Diane. I appreciate it. All right, I'm going to do this one, and I'm going to send this out to all of you because you are so beautiful to me. And that's not the song I'm doing, but I will send it out to all of you because of that. Where I turn, I can't get over you, and the flame still burns. It makes no difference, night or day. The shadows never seem to fade away, and the sun don't shine anymore. And the rains fall down on my door. Now there's no love as true as the love that dies untold, but the clouds never hung so low before. It makes no difference how far I go, like the scar the hurt will always show. And it makes no difference who I meet, if it's a face in the crowd on a dead end street. And the sun don't shine anymore. And the rains fall down on my door. These old love letters I just can't keep. Like the gambler says, read 'em and weep. And the dawn rescue me no more. Without your love, I am nothing at all, like an empty heart. hole. It's a lonely fall. Since you've been gone, it's a losing battle. Stampeding cattle, they rattle the walls. And the sun don't shine anymore. On my door, I love you so much, and it's all I can do just to keep myself from telling you that I've never felt so alone before. Thank you for all that you do to support music, both with me and with everyone else. It's really appreciated and it's really needed right now. And you know, there's good news on the horizon. Sometime in the next few months, we'll be out of this. And for the next few months, I'll be right here. So I'll see you on Thursdays. Make sure you tell some people. Make sure you like and subscribe on that YouTube channel. Very important to me. And if you would like to send a tip, you may send it there. If you're not interested in that and you would like to just get a hold of me for some reason, these are the places you can find me. So hopefully I'll see you soon. Have a great Thanksgiving, because I will not be performing on Thanksgiving Thursday, I don't think. You never know. If you subscribe to the YouTube channel, you put the little bell, you'll know if I change my mind. Otherwise, I will see you in 2 weeks, which is December 3rd. I will be back with a very special guest, and it's going to be a lot of fun. And we'll be preparing for the Christmas Spectacular. It's going to be coming. It's coming. December 17th. It's going to be so much fun. All right. We will see you soon. Love you all. Have a great, great night. Good night, everybody.